Hello, this is Dr. Gary Hawkins with the University of Georgia Crop and Soil Science Department and UGA Extension. Today we will be demonstrating how to use the Enviroscape Watershed Model. Funding for this video has been in part from Georgia's EPD 319 program. Today we're going to use the Enviroscape Watershed Model to concentrate on the industrial site in the upper corner of the model. Included in your kit is an industrial plant. This could be an industry within your town or community. When I use the model with kids, I like to say it's a chocolate factory or some other factory that they might recognize. For purposes of today, I'm going to take the bridge out so we can see the trench or the ditch that runs from the factory to the creek. For purposes of this demonstration, I will say this is a chocolate factory. The first thing we want to do is fill our lake with a cup of water as referenced in your manual, so I'll go ahead and pour in some water. Now let's discuss the industry. If an industry discharges anything from the plant itself, it will receive an NPDES permit or National Pollutant Discharge Elimination System permit, which will allow them to discharge a given amount of whatever they produce. In this case, if it's chocolate syrup, they can discharge so many grams of chocolate syrup per liter per day into the creek. Whatever syrup they discharge is factored into the TMDL, or the total maximum daily load, for that specific creek receiving that load from the factory. The total maximum daily load is the largest amount of pollutants a water source can take in without disrupting the overall health of the water body. Now let's say there has been a leak at the chocolate factory. Something happened to one of the pipes in the factory while no one was watching. The pipe broke and the contents ran into a drain that discharges into the stormwater drain. Let's demonstrate this. As you can see, our factory has a hole in the top of the building. I've mixed some green drink mix with water to make our sludge, and I'm going to use a small syringe to squeeze some of our sludge into the hole. Now, as you can see, some of that liquid will run out of the pipe in the back of the industry, through our ditch, and down our creek here. Obviously, that is not going to be good for the health of our lake. So what are we going to do about this pollution? There are cars on the Enviroscape model, so we can say after we've run some of the liquid, in this case, down the creek, that a car is driving along here and notices that there is a discoloration in the creek, or in case of our demonstration, someone smells chocolate when they get near the creek. At this point, one of the things this person could do is call the local office of EPD and let them know that there's green substance in the creek. From that point, an environmental agency person would test the creek water. In order to find the source of the green liquid, they would check the water or soil to determine where it starts and stops. By walking the creek starting at the pond and moving upstream, they notice that discoloration stops at the pipe coming from the industry. There's green in this case below the pipe coming from the industry, and it's clear above the pipe. They would follow that trench up and notice that the industry has a leak coming out from the pipe in the back. This identifiable source of pollution is called point source pollution. Point source pollution can be remembered as something you can point to and identify as a cause of pollution. We can point to this pipe, so it's a point source pollution. Now remember that industries are permitted to discharge a given amount of material with their NPDES permits, and that given amount of material meets the requirements of discharges to the creek if the creek can assimilate that material, assuming that it's non-toxic and does not disrupt the overall health of the system. From there, we could go back to the agricultural side of the model. If we had our cows here, and if these cows are just allowed to walk in the creek, they could and would drink some of the water in the creek, which contains chocolate syrup in our case. Cows may not like chocolate syrup. Depending on the compound in the water, this could make the cow sick. Again, the industry is part of the watershed and is a form of point source pollution because we can look at it, point to it, and identify it as direct cause of pollution. This video has been used to show how the industry portion of the Enviroscape Watershed Model can be used to teach about point source pollution. This is Dr. Gary Hawkins with the University of Georgia and UGA Extension. Thank you.